Perfect. All right. So we're ready to. Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Tuesday. I'm Mary Ann here with Blue Chip International Realty. It is my pleasure to host today's webinar with our special guest, Ms. Lori Tarver. She is the Vice President of Sales and Marketing for Park Square Homes. She'll be sharing some expert knowledge regarding new home construction and go into a little more detail about her position with Park Square Homes. If you're just now coming aboard or haven't followed us yet, Blue Chip International Realty is a full-service real estate company. We are here to guide our clients every step of the way during real estate and sales transactions. To help make the process a smooth one, we have a team of very talented realtors that speak multiple languages, such as Spanish, Chinese, English, Portuguese, Indonesian, and French. And we, of course, specialize in residential and commercial real estate. On this call, we have our broker, Michelle Ping. You want to say hello?
Hi, everybody.
As Hi, place, which is an agent for us for Blue Chip International Realty, and Ms. Fong Cook, which is our office manager. Hey, guys. How are you guys?
Hey, everyone. Thank you.
Hey, thank you for having us today.
Of course. All right, Fong. So if you want to take it away and start with our questions. Yeah. And
yes, it's my absolute pleasure to be here today. And Lori, may I just say, so nice to have you here today with us to chat with us. And thank you so much for making the time out of your super busy schedule and make this happen. I understand that you and Shell, wow, man, two very, very successful ladies have been working together on our Bella Vita project and have become pretty close friends. And so therefore I've heard a lot about you. And they're all good things. And I'm just truly excited to have you here today. So without further ado, I'm going to start our Q&A sessions. I know that Marianne has mentioned that Lori has been with a very solid background in sales and marketing. Lori has been an executive for several major home builders such as Lennar, Metamie Homes, and currently she's a VP of sales and marketing for Park Square Homes. So my very first question, Laura, is how are you doing during this quarantine?
Well, the worst part of this quarantine is I've not gotten to go to dinner or to have drinks with my friend Chell. That's like the worst part, okay? Because we've been sequestered and not been able to be together. Actually, during this quarantine, it's been a really interesting time in my life. I've been in the industry for over 35 years. I've never seen anything like this. I've gone through a lot of ups and downs and recessions, but I've never been through a global pandemic. I don't think any of you have either. So it's uncharted waters for all of us. But for me and my family, the main thing is we're just trying to be safe. We're trying to be smart. We're focusing on our health and we're focusing on family. And so it's, I have an interesting background. I'll just tell you real quick. There are four generations that live in my house. I have a 91-year-old mother. She turned 91 on Friday, May the 8th. I have a wonderful husband. And then I have a daughter who's 30, and she has two children, two little darling girls. One is 7 and one is 1. So there are four generations in our house, and we've been sequestered together for 8 weeks. 8 weeks, right? So we have learned to play a lot of board games and just had fun. And we turned off the TV because, you know, TV is always, right now it's just bad news. So you just turn it off. And we play lots of different board games and have fun together. And we've just done our best to make this a really wonderful family memory. And we've stayed home to stay safe.
Oh, so wonderful to hear. That's a blessing. You know, I wish I had families here with us, so my girls would get off the iPad any screen too, but not for our house, but I let them have the iPad so that I can keep my sanity. Have you been working from home too, or some in and out office as well?
You know, I'm really blessed. We work for, Park Square Homes is a family owned business. We are privately held. And it's a minority-owned business, and the most wonderful thing I can say about the people that own this company is not only are they brilliant businessmen, but they're also family-oriented, and they are amazing philanthropists. I mean, just last week, just in like a 3 or 4 day time period, we raised like $10,000 for a local charity here, and it was just through our employees. It was just through our employees, and everybody pitched in, and just took care of the local, you know, we take care of our own. We are Central Florida's hometown builder, and we take that motto very seriously. But the great thing is because we're owned by a family, they care about us and our families. So as of March 16th, I was sent home and told you can work remote. And I've been working remote for over almost two months now. And right now the plan is for all of us to come back on June 1st. But it's been wonderful because of things like this, because of Zoom, because of different video conferences that you can do. We haven't missed a beat. We haven't missed a closing. We haven't missed a sale. We're all working. We may be working even harder from home because we're really, really focused on trying to, you know, keep everything going. But I've been blessed that I've been able to work from home. I'm actually in the Park Square offices today because I had a meeting I needed to go to. But for the most part, I've been able to work from home, and I'm just so thankful to work for people like Suresh and Vishal Gupta who really care about their employees and make us kind of feel like their family too.
Oh, that's so wonderful. I've heard nothing but good about the owners of Park Square Homes. I can see that's obvious. I mean, that's why people like to work from people like you, successful like you, will work for them. You kind of already answered my next question.
I have heard about Park Square for a long time. I admired them from a distance for a long time before I started working for them because they've just earned such a beautiful reputation as just amazing people, but people that take care of their own. And it's just a great place to work. The core values are second to none. As you mentioned a while ago, I've worked for a lot of home builders. I've been in this business a very, very long time. And you know, our business, home building, is kind of nomadic. People are kind of like gypsies. They go from one builder to another, and I'm no different. But for a long time, I'd heard about Park Square and how they're just really good people and how they take care of their employees almost as well as they take care of their customers. And so it's a company that I've admired from afar, and I've been blessed to work here. I've only been here a year, but I got here as quickly as I could.
Wow, that's the core though for a successful business is you take care of your own people, your people take care of your customers, and your customers will in turn take care of your business.
Absolutely, you got it.
That's awesome to hear. So I guess you already, do you want to tell us more about your background and what you do like for Park Square on a daily basis? How's your day look like?
Well, I'm blessed. I tell you, I've got the greatest job in the world. It's never a dull moment because I am over sales and marketing, which means I work with some of the best and brightest people at Park Square Homes. We have about 50 salespeople. I have four sales managers. I also have the privilege of being over the design studio. So we have excellent, excellent options for our buyers to actually adorn their homes and personalize them, customize them in their own way. And then I also have kind of what we call the back of the house process, which is the closing that takes it from the contract all the way to close of escrow. So I have the sales, I have the marketing department, I have the closing department and design studio, and it's so fun. It's the fun side of the business for sure. We just do a lot of fun things. So in one Zoom conference, we might be working on a billboard. In the next Zoom conference, we are decorating a model. In the next Zoom conference during this pandemic time, we might be pricing, you know, a brand new community that's about to come out of the ground. So it's always something that's exciting and fun. That's why I love the sales side of our business.
Oh my goodness. So great to see that passion and the energy, the passion you have. I can tell you love your job. Not many people, not a whole lot of people can say that, but I'm...
Well, Fang, in all fairness, I'm kind of older than Dirk, and I've had a lot of jobs that I didn't like. So once I got here, I just love it. I just love it. I'm very blessed. So, you know, maybe there's others out there that love what they're doing, but I've kissed a few frogs before I found the prince, you know?
Don't we all, but you're in the right place.
Yes.
That's awesome. So in your opinion, you already kind of mentioned that they're very family oriented. They really focus on family values. What other things that sets Park Square Home apart from other builders that you worked with?
Well, I think a lot of it is if you think about the big builders, and you mentioned their names, I won't mention them, but if you think about the big builders, they care more about Wall Street we care about Main Street. We care about the people in Central Florida. All of our philanthropic efforts are right here. All of our home building, we build throughout Tampa and we build throughout Orlando. So we have many communities all throughout the Tampa Bay and the Orlando area. And we care about each of those communities. And so it's just really neat because we care so much about our customers and getting it right, getting the house right the first time. So we really focus on our customers. One of our core values is customer obsessed. And that's just really, really important to us. Whereas, as I said, a lot of other builders, they care about what Wall Street thinks. They care about their return on investment. Now, don't get me wrong. We want a good return on investment. But we don't want it at the expense of customer satisfaction. We always want to take care of our customers first.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. You can, you know, what a great ambassador you are.
So I have to tell a story on that because, you know, as realtors and brokers, we do final work through a lot for new construction home. And some of the builders, when we do the final work through, there's too many issues that we cannot even handle. So we have to hire a professional inspection company for new construction homes. But for the homes that we closed with Park Square, we never really have any issue because they normally have a team of builders. They follow you around in the home and then there's nothing on your punch list while closing. That is really, you know, the best experience you can have as the realtor. And you will, like, that's how you will convince your buyer that, see, look, I recommend a builder, I recommend a home to you, and look how good the home is. They will end up spread the good word not only for their home, but also for you.
Oh, thank you for sharing that, because that's personal endorsement there, and it's what we strive for. So thank you for sharing that.
I've had the privilege of working with one of your super awesome project managers, and he's just so on point. When we do the final walkthrough, he fixed everything right there, right then. If not, it's going to be the next day. But in the morning, he would tell me, hey, come in and check on the few things that I haven't, you know, that I haven't done yesterday. And I went, everything's taken care of. So that's just such a wonderful thing. You know, it goes to the reputation of Park Square Home, for sure. Now we're going to the homes itself. So are your model homes currently open to walk-in clients or strictly by appointments or virtual appointments?
Well, you know, during the hardest time in COVID-19, we were open virtually by appointment only, but we opened up yesterday. We actually opened all of our sales centers yesterday. Now, I want you to please understand we are still extremely cautious. We care so much about our customers. We are customer obsessed. We also care about our own employees. One of our other core values is one team, one family. So we are very careful. We've taken a lot of extra precautions. We do extra cleans of our models. We are constantly wiping down and sanitizing before and after every customer leaves. We also restrict how many people can come in the sales center at a time. And so if we have two models in a model park, we make sure that, you know, the first group has gone to the second model before we let them any more in the first model. So we're absolutely following the CDC guidelines of not allowing more than 10 people at a time. And we have no handshake. We wave and we do hearts, but we don't hearts. Let's see. We do hearts, but we don't do any handshaking right now. And we have hand sanitizer everywhere. My 7-year-old granddaughter calls it a hand-sitizer. Hand-sitizer. She kind of runs it all together. So I started calling it a hand-sitizer. But we have hand-sitizer everywhere so that our customers really feel good, you know, can really feel like they're being taken care of. And so it's important to us to be safe. But yes, we are open as of yesterday.
That's great because that takes care, you know, that just shows you really care about your customers and to try to protect them during this very sensitive time. And by the way, where did you get your sanitizer from?
I have a case right now.
All right, I'll stop by.
Yeah, stop by. I'll fix you up. I'll hook you up, girl.
Thank you. Well, our focus today for this webinar is to talk about the advantages of new home construction. So can you educate us, what is involved in the process of a new construction home from beginning to the end? And this question is actually from our fellow realtor, Esther.
Okay. Well, in essence, whenever you buy new construction, it is very different than the resale market. Number one, nobody's ever lived in the home before. And so we are seeing many people that had never considered buying new coming to buy new now because they're not as interested in a home that someone else has been in because everybody's worried. Everybody, and I don't spread fear. I'm not a fear monger. But people realize that if someone has never lived in the home, then, you know, it's clean, it's sanitized. One of the things that we are doing right now is we have hired a company, and while our customers are at the closing table, while they're at our title company, we actually go in and totally sanitize their entire home so that no builder, no trade, no carpenter, nobody has been in there from the time that it was sanitized until they put their new key in their new front door. So that's one of the things that we do. And another difference with new homes versus resale, they're both incredibly vital to the success of our economy. I saw a statistic recently that if there were 10 homes sold in the United States, if that were the number 10, that 6 of those would be resale. So 60% of the market is resale. It's vital to our economy. But so are new homes. And so the folks that are choosing new homes, one of the reasons is that they really do want that new. They want to be the first person to walk on that carpet, the first person to use that oven, that sort of thing. In addition to that, the warranties. There's always warranties on a new home, whereas on a resale home, you may have some kind of a homeowner's warranty, something that's purchased, a secondary insurance policy that's purchased on that home. But the nice thing is, you know, the water heater's covered, the stove is covered, you know, there's a lot of different warranties, the dishwasher, a lot of things that are covered in a new home that are not necessarily covered in a resale home. In addition to that, federal law says that all home builders in a new home have to warrant the structure of the home for 10 years. So every new home comes with a federal mandated 10-year structural warranty, which gives people comfort, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. I think when we purchase a home, we tend to think the resale homes are, you know, fit our budget better. But I mean, the new constructions can be very competitive in pricing and in the warranties you give you in terms of giving you a peace of mind, nothing, you know, everything is new. So that goes to my next question, the base package that Parktra Home offers. What does that include, let's say, for a residential home? Appliances?
Yeah.
Washer, dryer.
Well, it depends. It depends on the community. You know, I'm sure all of you have heard of some of the big builders right now that are doing kind of a more affordable product, such as LGI Homes or D.R. Horton Express or Starlight by Ashton Woods. Well, we have a new product line like that, and it's called Thrive. Isn't that what everybody wants to do? We want to
love it,
right? So we have a brand new community that's going to be opening within the next month. And it is out in Haines City, and it's called Tarpon Bay. And in Thrive, all of the appliances are included. And so it includes washer, dryer, refrigerator, stove, oven, which are usually one and the same, stove, oven, dishwasher, but it also includes blinds. And so we've found that someone moving from an apartment has just enough money to get in, but they may not be able to go buy drapes. They may not be able to make curtains even. And they don't have the money to go buy a refrigerator or washer and dryer. So in the more affordable homes, we're seeing a movement in the marketplace of trying to include all of those things. So it depends on the market niche in answer to your question, because some of our other homes that are, let's just say, higher priced or larger homes, maybe they are in the $300,000 or $400,000 or even $500,000 price range. Most of the people that buy those already have a washer and a dryer and a refrigerator, and they may have paid big bucks for it and really don't want to leave it in the resale that they just sold to someone else. So it depends on the price point and the demographic, whether we include all of the appliances. But we have this new product line called Thrive that's just going to be fantastic in Tarpon Bay. You'll be hearing more about that later. We're going to do a big splash in the marketplace in the next couple of months.
Yeah, it sounds really exciting, just the name alone, Thrive. Yeah. Thank you. That's interesting. It's interesting. So here's my part I've done. I'm going to turn over to Zane. He's going to ask you the next session of the questions, okay?
Thank you.
Also, I want to ask all their attendees, if you have any other additional questions, you can just let them know in the chat, and then at the end, I'll read over them if they have any questions.
Okay. So now we're just going to kind of jump from talking about a little bit of the premise to the actual like on the ground picking of options and a little bit what customers like and what you guys offer with that package. You answered a little bit about, or pretty much all of what I was about to ask when it comes to appliances. But besides appliances, washers and dryers, what are some of the most popular upgrades and options that you see on residential homes for new construction?
That's a really good question. And it varies depending on the market niche, but I think across the board, you could say that most people would like to have a solid surface flooring throughout the first floor. They're maybe not in the bedrooms, but going from the kitchen into the gathering room or the family room, we're seeing that most people don't want to have carpet in that family room. And so most builders put carpet because carpet is less expensive than a lot of the hard surfaces are. So we're seeing people that would like to have that. We also see a lot of open railing. So people don't really want the half wall going up the stairs. They want the open look. So we see a lot of people choosing the open railing. And also, the front elevation of the home, the architecture of the front of the home, what does it look like from the street scene? People really want their home to be unique and be theirs. And so as a home builder, we usually have anywhere from 2 to 3, sometimes 4 different front architectural choices. And those are actually chosen at the point of sale in the sales center. In the design center, we see a lot of people, granite's still big. People may think granite's going out and quartz is coming in, but good old Ubatuba, which is probably one of the most popular granite colors ever, Ubatuba is still going strong. Black Galaxy, some of those are still going strong. We're seeing a lot of people move to more of the like white cabinets and gray cabinets. Gray cabinets are very popular right now. And so we've kind of gone to, in our resort, which is our vacation homes, as well as our Thrive, so kind of opposite ends of the price spectrum, we've gone to packages where people can get white cabinets and then all the things that go with those white cabinets, or they can get gray cabinets and the things that go with it. So we make it very easy where they can come in and say, I want that package right there. So we kind of do a gray or a white or espresso. So those are kind of the popular colors and popular options right now, Zane.
Okay, great. So speaking of Thrive, I know we just talked a little bit about it, but so in your research, or I guess Park Squares, what do you expect to be amongst the most popular floor plans or styles of floor plans for Thrive? Because mainly this question revolves around first-time home buyers. And since that's a neighborhood that's going to be geared towards first-time home buyers, I figure it's best to talk about that.
That sounds good, Zane. I like the way you tied those two together. So, yes, so in the Thrive product, what we looked at, and we did a lot of research of the competitors, and we did a lot of market research of the buyers that are out there right now. And basically, they're just looking for being able to have a home, to be out of the apartments, to actually have a space that has a backyard that they can call their own. And so a lot of the things that they are looking for is normally, most of them either want 2-bedroom or 3, and we all know, being in resale, that 3-bedroom sells a lot better than 2-bedroom does. So we build 3-bedroom homes, but a lot of people don't use all 3 of those rooms as bedrooms. They may use 2 of them as bedrooms. Maybe if it's a single person, they have their own bedroom, they have a guest room, and then they have the 3rd bedroom that they might use for for an office or for a craft room or whatever, a hobby room, something like that. And so we're seeing that the first-time home buyer is really interested in payment, trying to figure out what is my payment. It is not, it's not as much of a style or design. However, we have found that the contemporary look is more popular right now than, let's say, a Mediterranean or a Tuscan or something like that, which is nice because, as all of you are aware, the type of architecture that's contemporary is clean lines, and so it's straight lines, and it's not as expensive to build as a Mediterranean or something that would have a tile roof, something like that. And so we've found that the designs that we've come up with for Thrive are that they're very simple, they're very straightforward, but they provide at an entry-level price that people can truly move out of an apartment and pay roughly the same amount of money and against P&I, principal and interest, and be able to actually own a home rather than renting.
And when it comes to first-time homebuyers, one of their biggest concerns is the newfound out-of-pocket costs that come with homeownership averse to renting. How is Park Square's overall home warranty program structured, and what are the details that really could benefit them in the long run being a first-time homebuyer?
Well, it really is kind of the difference between resale and new homes, because in resale, a lot of times, I mean, I bought a resale home when I moved to Orlando from Texas, and I didn't realize all the things that could possibly go wrong in the money pit that I bought. So as a result, I, just kept spending money after money after money going, what broke today, right? Now, that's not true in all resale, of course. But the nice thing about a new home is all of those things that broke in my current home would all be warranted if I'd been in a brand new home. So one of the things that's nice for a first-time home buyer is they are used to living in an apartment. They're used to if the faucet breaks, the landlord comes and fixes it. Okay. So the nice thing is when you are buying a new home, if something were to not work right or were to break, it is under warranty. So we have a 1 year that covers mechanicals and electrical, mechanical, that sort of thing. So if something goes wrong, and then some of our appliances, like in Thrive, we have a 3 year on our appliances. They're all Samsung appliances. So we have a 3 year on washer, dryer, refrigerator, stove. So it's a pretty good safety net for someone who doesn't want, as you called it, the out-of-pocket expenses. They just don't have it. And so it is it's a pretty safe bet to buy new because of those warranty programs.
Okay. When it comes to down payment, does Park Square offer any sort of down payment programs? Do they have any sort of assistance resources, not just for Thrive or for first-time homebuyers, but across the board when it comes to residential construction?
Well, I think we all know that every builder out there has some sort of incentive, has something that they offer, right? So we have a program where if we have an incentive in a community, let's just say it's $10,000, then what we do is we would allow the customer to either use that towards closing costs, or they might take it in upgrades. Maybe they wanted that open railing or that hardwood floor throughout the first floor family area. So we always have some sort of an incentive program, and we've found that the higher up in the price point, the more they use it for options. The lower in the price point, they might use it for closing costs. And so also I'll mention, just by way of example, like USDA, Thrive is in a USDA market, so it is eligible for USDA. And so that means no money down. So they actually pay money down for us to build a home, but then all of that is given back to them at the closing table. So we have many programs where a lot of times we cover all the closing costs, but not always. Sometimes it depends. If they say, I'd rather put, you know, let's just say for discussion's sake that it was a $5,000 incentive, they might put $3,000 towards closing costs and $2,000 towards some sort of upgrade that was important to them. Let me mention, though, also that in Thrive, in that particular program, there are no options. So there are no big decisions that have to be made. We build the homes, and we put all the cabinets and everything in it. We professionally design them. We have a professional designer that selects all the selections. We build them. And so when you go to buy the home, you have one price, just like you do in resale. You have one price, and that's the price of the home. And it's not a matter of, well, there's a base price of, you know, $250, but then you add $50,000 more in upgrades, so it's really $300. So Thrive is a real different product line for us, and it's very simple and very easy for the customer to say, what I see is what I get, and there's no hidden cost.
No surprises.
That's nice. And so some of the other questions we get a lot when it comes to dealing with new clients, especially when it comes to being either first-time home buyers or investing in new construction, they're, especially with everything going on right now, they're curious about how the market's going to move forward. And everybody we've talked to, we kind of asked this question too. And everybody seems to have a lot of confidence, but they all have a slightly different opinion. So what is your prediction for the local market now that everything's starting to move forward in the sense of like a 3 to 6 month midterm?
So, you know, if I knew the answer to that question, I'd be a very rich lady because I would know exactly where to invest right now, right? So I don't have an official Park Square answer, needless to say, because I'm the spokesman for the company, but not on that topic. What I will say, though, Zane, is I've been in this business a long time, and as I mentioned earlier, I've seen a lot of the ups and downs. I remember 2008 very well. I remember 2010 very well, and, you know, the ups and downs in this crazy thing called home building and real estate. So I will just say from my standpoint, I see that we have already rebounded from last month. So Park Square, we had a tough month last month. I'd say we did about half of what we expected to do. There are many home builders in our marketplace that ended up at net zero, meaning they sold a certain amount of homes and canceled the exact same amount. There are national builders that had zero net sales in the month of April. We didn't. We sold about half as many as we expected, and that's okay. The good thing is we were able to cover all of our cancellations and still have a net of half of the number. We are already, here we are, today is May 12th, we're already at the same net number for May that we were in April. So I'm already seeing the market coming back, and I'm very optimistic and I'm encouraged by that. I will say that if you look at the product lines, I think that the lower end is going to come back quicker, and then the middle, and then the top. And we all know that in the top is your vacation homes, et cetera. I think they're going to come back slower. I think the parks are going to have to be open. All of the wonderful attractions that Orlando is known for, those are going to have to be open and up and running, et cetera, before we really see a full rebound in that type of the market. So I really don't have a crystal ball, Zane, but I am cautiously optimistic. And already this month, I feel a resurgence of sales. I mean, I get offers while we've been sitting here. I've had two offers come across on my cell phone. So it feels good. It feels like the market's going to rebound rather quickly.
Yeah, great. That's about what everybody seems to hope for and pray for. And we seem to be moving towards that. So thank you for answering that question. And thank you for kind of explaining everything today about Park Square, because you guys are really, truly a full service builder. And that can offer pretty much everything in-house. And that kind of leads to my final question. I kind of saved it for the end to kind of wrap it up. What are some of the benefits that somebody would have by using your in-house services, your mortgage, your title, in lieu of using multiple services from third parties? Because you guys really do offer everything. And I apologize if that question's kind of out of order. It was kind of thrown in there at the last minute because it was one of the more popular ones we received.
Not a problem. I appreciate you answering it because it really is exactly what you just said. It rather than going hither and yon to try and piece everything together yourself, it's a matter of one-stop shopping. You come into one of our sales centers or call us. I mean, we've sold homes virtually. We've sold homes where people have never been on site, they've never seen the home, but we go around with a camera and we show them the home, and we're able to, you know, we're able to take care of them just, I mean, email them a contract and have them, you know, DocuSign it, et cetera. But what's great about Park Square is we have our own mortgage company, and it's a partnership with FBC, and we have where anytime you go into one of our sales centers, then you can sit down, you can get pre-qualified with a loan officer. It's Park Square Homes Mortgage. And like I say, it's a joint. We disclose up front, of course, that we own part of the company. And they get pre-qualified. We then know exactly what we can work with them on and what's comfortable within their budget. Then they come into our design studio and they make their selections right here in our corporate office. And then we build the home for them. And then at the end, they actually go to your building where Park Square Homes Title is located in the building that you guys office in, right down the street from us. And so it's all one team, one family, truly. It's a core value, but it's also something that we believe in for our customers that we take care of them all the way from day one, all the way past closing.
Great. So thank you again very much for being with us today. And I'm going to kind of flip this back to the people watching with us. So there are some takeaways to keep in mind from today. You've definitely heard from our expert, Lori. There are tons of advantages in purchasing a new construction home. For one, pricing can be very competitive and free, and the home is going to be free of problems for a long time is the second feature that I think is one of the most important, especially with the warranty features. You'll find some of the newest amenities in new communities, as opposed to a resale community, which was built 15 years ago, may not have any amenities built into them at all. All these kind of add up to a real great features that you see in new construction, and are really some of the best reasons to consider new construction in the market today.
Yeah. Well, definitely. Thank you for that, Zane. Okay, so I'm going to check and see if we have any questions in the chat.
So I heard you guys have a new program called 2020 Down Payment. Can you give us a little bit insight?
Yes, we came up, we thought we were kind of clever there with 2020, since it's year 2020, right? So we came up with a couple of things, 2020 for a down payment. And the way that it works, you know, a lot of people, a lot of builders, including us, require something like $10,000 down. And there's a lot of people going, I don't exactly have $10,000, you know, handy that I can part with right now. And so we came up with this program where the earnest money is $2,020 when you buy a home from us right now, whether it is a home that is an inventory home or it's you pick the land, the piece of dirt, and we build it on it, right, in one of our communities. So whether it's a to-be-built or whether it's inventory, the earnest money is $2,020 at the time of contract. And then you have 60 days to actually come up with the remainder of the earnest money, which is nice because then people can save for it. And so the actual down payment, the actual EMD, is based on whatever their loan is. So if they have a FHA and it's 3.5%, then they know exactly if it's 3.5%, it's a $300,000 home. I don't do math well, but it's somewhere around $9,000, right? So they have to pay the $2,020 at time of contract, and the remainder they can pay out over a period of time. So it's a really good program because it's getting a lot of people that are renters and they've saved a couple of grand, but they haven't saved more than that. So it's able to open some doors for them. And also, I would assume that some of your folks watching, are they mostly buyers or are they mostly realtors?
So we have a good mix of all. We have our team, our agents, and then we're also on Facebook Live. So anyone was more than welcome to join. So we do have a mix.
Great. Well, we have something for everyone because right now we also have a bonus program of 2020 for the realtors. And so we see a lot of realtors that come in and they realize that this is the right fit for their customer, and we happen to reward them for that. And then we have this wonderful program. Not only do we have the 2020 program, but listen to this, all of you that are interested in buying a new home, right now we have a program of $20,020 in most of our communities. There's two or three that we don't have it in, so we have to read the fine print, such as Sawgrass, that we don't have it in, but we have a flex bucket of money of $20,020 that you can take up to $15,000 of that and use it for closing costs. And the difference you can apply to options that are in your home. So we really took this 2020 thing seriously because we've got something for the realtors, something for the customers and their earnest money down, and then something for the customers as they're trying to select what do they want for closing costs, what do they want in options, that sort of thing. So it's a very robust program that we've got going on. We started at the end of April and we're running it all through the month of May.
We need something positive for this number, right? 2020. It's been hell of a year already. Feels so long.
You're right.
Actually, I have a question I kind of had in mind. Do you currently have any pre-construction, have any inventory homes in Orlando?
We have a lot of inventory homes. We sure do. We believe in having inventory homes because a lot of times people will list their home and then start looking for a new home and then their home sells like that. You know, they're like, oh my goodness. True. Realized that I was going to have 30 days on the market. I thought I would have, you know, 3 months on the market. So we have homes in various stages of construction. We have some that have just started. We've got some that are, you know, maybe they'll be ready in the next month, some that will be ready in 2 months. Just by way of example, up in Orange City, Encompass Landing, as recently as January of this year, we had 10 inventory homes, and they were in various stages of completion. And at this moment, we have one left. They've all sold. So it's a matter of people are looking at it, falling in love with it. We have some amazingly beautiful floor plans that are just really geared right for today's buyer. And so as a result, we've been selling just like that in Compass Landing. That's our community in Orange City. And so we built 10 beautiful homes, and sure enough, they sold. And just this morning, I was in a meeting. They were like, choose more inventory homes for Compass Landing. And I said, I'm on it.
That's awesome. So back in April, you mentioned you guys were doing well, you know, pretty well given the situation. Were the most buyers or first-time buyers, or they were by out of state, or they're local? Or
you know, we had some from out of state, but we were very careful because we would ask the questions, you know, what state have you been in, and you know, how long have you been in Florida? You know, so we were very, very careful to be protective of our team members. But it wasn't mostly first-time home buyers. I mean, we sold out last month. We sold out Markham Square, and we also sold out Serenity Cove, and those are $600,000 homes. So they certainly weren't, you know, first-time home buyers. So we really had it all over the board, Fang. Anywhere from our entry level of our townhomes all the way through. We sold some resort homes last month as well.
Wow!
So how many? How many new communities you have right now? Are they majorly in Orlando area, or is more of in greater Orlando area?
Yeah, it's really more what I call a greater Orlando area to me, which includes Tampa, because to me it all runs together. It's all Central Florida, and you know, I know that drive so well back and forth. And I would just say we have about 10 communities in Tampa. We have about 15 communities in Orlando. And the only reason I say about that many and don't give you the exact number is that we are closing out. We have like 4 left in Verona. I've got 3 left in Segovia. I've got 2 left in Harbor Shores. So we are closing out of some communities because they've just been so successful. We've sold out. And then we have some communities that are coming online. We have a brand new community in Davenport that is right next to Golden Ridge called Redbridge Square. And we opened it during a pandemic, and we've already sold 6 homes there in 3 weeks. And so it's and under normal conditions, you'd say, well, that's pretty good sales. But in the middle of a pandemic, it's really good sales.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah. It's good to know. It's encouraging. The buying power is still there, some of it. still buying.
Well, it is difficult. I will share with you that, you know, a lot of builders are talking about their backlog because, you know, we all love to sell a home, but we make money when we close a home, right? And there are some of our buyers that have been affected by COVID-19. And we made a decision. We made a business decision. And these are the words of Vishal Gupta, one of the co-CEOs of our company. And I asked him, I said, when these folks are coming to me and they say, I lost my job, or I lost a loved one to COVID-19. I said, if they don't close on our home, they're in breach of contract because it's a legal black and white document. I said, what do I do? Because I'm the one that makes the decision of whether they get earnest money back.
Right.
His words were, we will not contribute to their hardship during this time of COVID-19. So I look at it, and every single one of them, if somebody lost their job, I ask them, can you give me a letter from your employer that tells me that it was based on the economic conditions of today? And if so, I will refund your earnest money. And so we've been very, very mindful and very respectful because we love Central Florida and we want to take care of everybody. Now, I will tell you, we did have one customer come in last week and go, oh, I found another house over across town that I liked a little bit better, so I went ahead and bought it. So I kept her earnest money, okay? So I'm not Snow White. I'm not Cinderella here with a magic wand. But it's a matter of, you know, if somebody's going through hard times, we don't want to contribute to that. And I loved it that one of the co-owners and co-CEOs of our company's words were, we will not contribute to their hardship. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah. It's heartwarming.
Good people.
Right. All right. Do we have any additional questions that we want to go over? I think we're coming to our end. I know it was 1 hour. Sure. You, Lori, are very busy.
Never too busy for my friend Chow, I will assure you.
Aww. No, we're all your friends, Lori.
Absolutely. You're right. Well, I've known Marianne quite a while, and Zane too, and Zane, you're my new friend. There you go.
Awesome. All right. Well, I think we're going to wrap up. Thank you so much, Lori, for taking out of your time and being with us. It was great seeing you. Thank you, Zane. I'm sure he probably had to run and get a call. Thank you, Zane, Fong, and Xiao for being here. We do these, try and do these every Tuesday with different people to come to speak and share their knowledge like you did today. But thank you guys so much.
Yeah, thank you, Lori. It's truly a pleasure of meeting you. I'm looking forward to meeting you in person and having a couple of drinks with you one day soon.
Oh, I'm going to hold you to that. That sounds great.
I love that.
We'll celebrate.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. And this video will be shared to all the realtors in our company. We have 20 realtors, as well as to be shared in our database. Hope, you know, we can get more traffic since it's starting to pick up.
It is.
Yeah, it was reassuring to hear, you know, your insight being an expert and also just, you know, something positive to look forward to for our real estate market. So thank you again.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you, everyone.
All right. Well, take care.
Thank you.
Have a fantastic rest of the week, Lori.
Thank you. You too.
Bye, guys.
Thank you.
Bye.